count the upper limb regarding the MCQs. We'll see what are the important MCQs. Number one, pectoral region and the axilla. And the pectoral region and the axilla, the most important MCQ is the sternal angle. Sternal angle corresponds to the cartilage of the second rib. And this corresponds to which disc? Disc between T3, T4 and T5. This is the first MCQ, sternal angle. Sternal angle is in the front and it corresponds to which vertebra? Between T4 and T5. Disc between T4 and T5. This is the first MCQ. Number two is nipple. Nipple, where it is situated? Everybody knows, in the fourth intercostal space, just medial to midclavicular line. And then third MCQ is axilla. Anterior axillary fold is formed by, everybody knows, it is in the front, so it is formed by the pectoralis major, and the posterior axillary fold is formed by latissimus dorsi and teres major muscle. Then if you come down, the next important MCQ is supraclavicular nerves. So you will be having the nerves which is coming up, that is third and fourth cervical nerves, it lies near the clavicle, that is called supraclavicular nerve. But here intercostal vehicle is very important, that will come later. And then axillary tail of Spence, this is very important. It ends or opens it at which level? It enters into the axilla at the third rib. This is MCQ, third rib. It is coming from the outer quadrant of the breast, that is axillary tail of Spence. And then if you come here, the next important thing is deltopectoral groove. Between the deltoid and the pectoralis major muscle, it is already shown in my spotters. Okay, deltopectoral groove. The deltopectoral groove is lying between the pectoralis major and delta. The contents of the deltopectoral groove are C and D. C for cephalic vein and D for deltoid branch of acromiothoracic artery. So, acromiothoracic artery branches are A, P, C and D. A for acromial, P for pectoral, C for clavicular and D for deltoid. This deltoid branch only, it is lying in the deltopectoral groove. Next is clavipectoral fascia. Structures covered by the clavicular, other muscles covered by the clavipectoral fascia enclosing muscles. One is pectoralis minor, another one is subclavius. These two muscles and the structures entering in and entering out are CALL, that everybody knows, cephalic vein, acromiothoracic artery, lateral pectoral nerve and lymphatics. The next MCQ is pectoralis major. Pectoralis major is supplied by lateral pectoral and medial pectoral nerve, and it also forms the anterior axillary fold. This is the anterior axillary fold. And then pectoralis major insertion is lateral lip. Pectoralis goes to lateral lip. Anterior major goes to medial lip of intertubercular sulcus. This is very important MCQ. And pectoralis major, as usual, three fibers are there: flex, clavicular fibers, sternocostal fibers and aponeurotic fibers. So three fibers are here. So this is the clavicular fiber, this causes flexion, and these are the sternocostal fibers which is horizontal, so it causes adduction, and the oblique fibers from the aponeurosis which causes the medial rotation. So these are the three fibers. And then axilla, when you come to the axilla, just now we saw about the anterior axillary fold, posterior axillary fold. Posterior axillary fold is formed by the behind, no? So teres major and the latissimus dorsi. And the apex is very important MCQ. What are the boundaries for the apex of the axilla? So here clavicle in the front, you can see the clavicle in the front, and here you have the scapula, and here you have the first rib. So first rib is here. So these three, they form the axilla, because your axilla is here, understand? So first rib, clavicle and the scapula. So again I repeat, clavicle, first rib and the upper border of the scapula, these three forms the apex, and base is formed by the axillary. And then if you come to the next chapter, that's most important question, intercostobrachial nerve. Intercostobrachial nerve is intercosto. So intercosto means which intercostal? Second intercostal. So second intercostal to brachium. Brachium means arm. So arm, which nerve is in the medial part of the arm? Medial cutaneous nerve of arm. So in second intercostal, which branch of second intercostal? Lateral branch, because it has to come from the arm. It should come laterally, you know. So intercosto brachial. Brachial is communicated with the medial cutaneous nerve of arm. So this is called as intercostobrachial. Second intercostal, lateral cutaneous branch of second intercostal. That is the MCG. Then if you come down, here it is seen clearly. Second intercostal emerges, communicates with the single branch. See? The lateral branch, this is important, very important. lateral branch of the second intercostal nerve emerges as a large branch, communicates with the medial cutaneous nerve of the arm and the lateral cutaneous branch of the third intercostal also. It also communicates with the third intercostal also. So second, it comes from the second, it also communicates with the third, second, the lateral branch, communicates with the medial cutaneous nerve of arm. Right, very important MCQ. Next MCQ is how to identify the ulnar nerve. First, identify the structure is, first is axillary vein, the next is axillary artery. So this is axillary artery. Between these two, you have the medial cutaneous nerve of forearm. Beneath the medial cutaneous nerve of forearm, we have the ulnar nerve, right? These are all MCQs. So medial most is medial cutaneous nerve of arm, next is axillary vein, the last is axillary artery. Between these two, medial cutaneous nerve of forearm is there. Just if you lift the medial cutaneous nerve of forearm, you could see the ulnar nerve, and this side if you lift the axillary artery, you could see the radial nerve. This is how you have to identify ulnar nerve and radial nerve. And then you have to write about this all. Okay, upper subscapular nerve supplies what? Upper subscapular nerve supplies upper part of the subscapularis, lower subscapular nerve supplies lower part of the subscapularis, anterior major. So many times we have revised this. And thoracodorsal nerves, thoracodorsal supplies nerve. This is also called as nerve to latissimus dorsi. So it supplies latissimus dorsi. And then axillary lymph nodes is a very important breast essay. It's very important. Central group of nodes are there. So which nerve passes through the central group of nodes? So which nerve from here, here to here, if a nerve comes, what's the nerve? Intercostobrachial nerve, MCQ. And then next is axillary artery. Axillary artery, the point is from where it is called the axillary artery, from the outer border of first rib, that outer border, and then up to the lower border of the teres, major, the MCQ. The next one is which structure divides, pectoralis minor divides it into three parts, and then first part, second part, third part, what are arteries? That is anterior circumflex humeral artery where it lies, posterior circumflex humeral artery where it lies. Anterior circumflex humeral artery, it will be lying in the intertubercular sulcus along with the latissimus dorsi as well as the important tendon which takes the intracapsular origin, that is your long head of biceps. So three structures are present in the intertubercular sulcus. What is this intertubercular sulcus? It is present in the humerus between the two tubercles, greater tubercle and a lesser tubercle. So in this you have the long head of biceps going through that, and the flow latissimus dorsi is getting inserted, and the most important anterior circumflex humeral artery is lying here. What about the posterior circumflex humeral artery? It will be lying along with the axillary nerve in the surgical neck of humerus. This is the surgical neck. So here is your axillary artery and posterior circumflex humeral arteries, right? And then what's the role of subclavius? Because you have to write it in the expulsy. So role of subclavius is holds the medial end of the clavicle. So what will happen? It keeps the medial end of the clavicle intact. So in expulsy it droops down. Okay, so then if you come here, sternoclavicular, brachial plexus, you might have read about everything about brachial plexus. I don't want to go in detail about the brachial plexus. Okay, suprascapular nerve supplies already. Suprascapular nerve supplies supra. So supraspinatus and infraspinatus. Nerve to subclavius. Long thoracic nerve is very important. C5, C6, C7. It is one among the two nerves coming from the root of the brachial plexus. Okay, another one now coming from the root of the brachial plexus is dorsal scapula. The long thoracic nerve bell, it supplies serratus anterior, and if the nerve is paralyzed, swinging of scapula is a clinical condition. Suprascapular, already we have seen all those stuff.